At the southeastern coast of South Africa is one of the most beautiful towns in the country, and a bay with an ocean shining like blue diamond hidden behind a dune. This is Orbit Mzansi in Port Elizabeth and at Sardinia Bay. Named Ibayi in Xhosa language, PE in short term, and known to the world as the beautiful Port Elizabeth, stretching 16 kilometers along Algoa Bay in South Africa's Eastern Cape province. It's the home of one of the major seaports in the country and the southernmost largest city on the continent, farther south than Cape Town. PE was founded in 1820 by the Cape Colony government with about 4,000 British colonists to strengthen the borders to the Xhosa land. Xhosa people already lived in the area since around 2,000 years. The first hunters and gatherers lived in the area 10,000 years ago. Today, PE has a population of over 312,000 people and is part of the Nelson Mandela Bay Metropolitan Municipality. Located between two climate zones, PE offers a dry winter season and a not too hot but windy summer season. A group of 30 volunteers led by Raymond Nklaba were one of the first protesters against the apartheid government in July 1952 as they walked to the new Brighton Civic Centre. In the mid-1980s, the protests in the townships of Port Elizabeth raised, demanding the integration of public institutions, the removal of troops and the end of workplace discrimination. Since 2001, PE is part of the Nelson Mandela Bay Metropolitan Municipality. In February 2021, several cities have been renamed as part of a government program to transform and decolonize the South Africa heritage landscape. Port Elizabeth was renamed to Gqeberha. Professional and hobby sportsmen well know PE for its annual Ironman triathlon and the Herald cycle tour. Anglers around the world come to PE for the Tuna Classic Deep Sea competition. Around 24,000 students study at the Nelson Mandela University. The city is connected to all major cities via the N2 highway, the intercity bus system, a local metro rail, the Shosholoza Merrill, airplane, and with Algoa Bay Harbour via sea. Algoa Bay is still one of the most important economic hubs for the region. As the garden route to Cape Town passes PE, it brings yearly a significant number of tourists to the town. Route 67 is a walking trail with 67 artworks symbolizing the 67 years Nelson Mandela dedicated to the freedom of South Africa. The most people in PE are speaking Afrikaans, English and Isi Xhosa. But as all through South Africa, all of the 11 official languages of the country are represented in PE. PE has a few rivers, as Barkens River is the most prominent. Like Cape Town and many other cities, PE has to fight with constantly returning devastating drought. Located at the southeastern part of the Port Elizabeth Airport is a hangar that homes one part of the South African Air Force Museum. As the museum doesn't charge an entrance fee, it is fully depending on donations of the few visitors it has. The other two parts of the museum are located in Swartkop outside Pretoria and Yesterplaat in Cape Town. The hangar was already used as air gunnery training center during the joint air training scheme in World War II. Here you can see the Aerospaziale SA-330L Puma, a helicopter with three seats and space for 16 more people and an empty weight of 3.6 tons. Also an Aermacchi AM-3C Bassback and a Yorg 4 skimmer foil are in the hangar. This plane is part of the Airspeed Oxford restoration program. Also, a number of North American Harvard are undergoing restoration here. This travel back in history worths the way to the museum, and we can only recommend it. Our planet is covered with places more beautiful than we could ever imagine. Sardinia Bay is one of these places, hidden behind a huge dune. The Sardinian Bay Marine Protected Area, a clearly defined area of long-term conservation of nature, was established in 1990 and is under the responsibility of the national government. The Marine Protected Area homes four major habitats in the sea with different nature of substrate that is important for the different organisms and animals living in the sea area. Many habitats are also mixed habitats. It's time to go underwater to see the rocky shores and reefs of Sardinia Bay and some fish. But even if you can't see it, life is everywhere here, like red bait pods, which are usually encrusted with sponges, ascidians, bryozoans, anemones, and gastropods, and abalone, which are usually covered by similar seaweeds to those found on the surrounding rocks. Other species and organisms can be found in the kelp forests, a variation of rocky reefs, and the sandy beaches and bottoms. Poaching of abalone and seaweeds, as well as illegal commercial and recreational fishing, are the major threat to the habitats and has already impacted stocks. Enjoy the beautiful world of Sardinia Bay.